What's up, everyone? You're listening to the third episode of True to Size. Hello, everyone. This is True to Size. My name is Alan Martinez. I am your host. I am alongside Joel Hernandez.
Yo, yo, yo.
Alvin Martinez.
How's it going, y'all?
And Lawrence Hopkins.
Howdy doody.
And we are Canada Got Soul. And we'd also like to apologize in advance for all the possible coughing and sneezing.
All four of us.
All the men are sick.
We all caught it on Soul Exchange.
From we all caught it.
Anyways, today we're going to go through a bunch of things, starting with another origin story. We're going to get into some heavy Jordan talk in a new segment called This Week in Kicks. Woo! Wow. We also take a look at a couple of our listener feedback and a few more things that I have in mind. I'm trying to get something to end this show fun.
Surprising.
Anyways, let's start with something that we did last week, and hopefully it goes a wee bit better. It's called rotations. We'll start it. What did you guys wear outside of work, Lawrence?
It's only been like 4 days since you reported the last episode.
Five? Is it
that,
four?
Oh, yeah. Four. I think that I've... Well, no. I took a couple of pictures this week, so I wore my Atmos Air Max 1s this week. But then every other day except for that day, I wore Black Cement 3s. So, segment over.
Your Air Max puns are incredible.
My what?
Oh, Air Max puns.
Those, you like those puns?
Yeah, I love them.
Not done
absolutely
yet.
Absolutely love
not
them.
Not done yet.
Thank God.
Air Max day.
I look forward to them almost every day. I have your notifications on, so...
I was going to start earlier in the month, but I didn't think of it until like the 15th of March, so...
I also don't think you have 30.
Yeah, that's also a problem. The amount of pairs would be an issue, but
Mr. Q-Mart.
Black Cement 3s were in there. Today was I had the Lunar Grands again for work. And then I think the 90s were there somewhere, like the Air Max 90s. Infrareds. I never took pictures, man. I don't have time right now, but I'll try to like be better next week.
It's okay.
We'll see what happens.
Joel Hernandez?
Well, I had on those Cork Air Max 1s that I got from Mr. Josh Shoa Findlay.
Shout out to Josh, though.
Shout out. And I also had on Vans, again.
Always.
And some Safari Talarias that I found at Dixie Nike.
Shout out to Dixie.
Shout out.
Such a good shoe.
Like, yeah, man.
There's like so many sleeper gems that I keep seeing you guys pick up from Dixie.
Good store. Everyone go to Dixie. No one go to Dixie. No one go to Dixie.
No.
What? There's an outlet at Dixie?
It's a Foot Locker one, no?
Yeah, Foot Locker outlet at Dixie Outlet Mall.
This week, I forgot what I've been wearing. Oh, I started off with the, what is that, the USA Air Max 1s. I think those were downstairs. I threw on a pair of Vapor Maxes. Black Cement 3s.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah, easily. And today, I believe I wore a pair of 1s.
Nice.
I'm like brain farting right now. I apologize, guys.
We're all quite under the weather.
Yeah, and also that's the last time you'll ever hear that rotation segment. Moving along, we're gonna go on to the Q-Mart origin.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Hi, Alvin.
Where did you come from?
Where did I came from? The Philippines. got to Canada in 1991.
Yeah.
I think that's about it.
I know that story.
End of the story. There we go. Next segment.
Oh my god. You're fired, Alvin. So, what started you in kicks?
The goat, man, MJ. The reason I was in the kicks in the first place was because of Michael the Jordan. Just seeing him play and seeing him just do the most amazing stuff, like live. Just, you know, when you wear the kicks, you're just like, yo, I'm going to play like Mike. So it's just like, that was it. And what started me was in grade 7 when I made the ball team. mother and father purchased me a pair of he got game 13s for ball. They said not the best ball shoe, but they're like, Bin, this is only for basketball, huh? And I was like, yeah, don't worry. First day to school, I wore them to school. I had to, man. Like, man, it was like my first pair of Jordans that I knew of anyway. But like, finding pictures later on, I had a pair of Aqua 8s. I had a pair of White Cement 3s when I was like probably 2 years old because my parents were swaggy like that. And yeah, man. So
actually?
Yeah.
That's
crazy, right?
I wasn't born yet.
So definitely was always into sneakers from like early on. I just couldn't afford to buy them myself. And then when I started to work at Walmart, funny story, Kuya Joel used to shop at the Square One Walmart.
Always.
So, but at this time when I was working at the paint department, I didn't know who he was. But I always knew him because he always had like the dopest kicks on. And I remember one time seeing him, he had like an LRG hoodie and he had some,
he used to rap LRG heavy.
Oh yeah.
And then, he had the black cement fours on. Ooh. And I was like, oh,
straight out of 2002.
Who is this guy?
So is that where you officially met her?
No, man, we met years after.
No way.
Like years after.
So how I think it was through a BBM group, no?
Yeah.
But then how did you know that was Joel shopping at Walmart?
Cause I knew, like, I knew his face, and then it was just. I asked him afterwards too. I was like, "Yo, did you ever used to shop at Walmart and wear your blacksmith fours all the time?"
That's actually so
that's
cool.
Crazy. Yeah, that's crazy.
I'm like, "Yeah, man."
That's such a crazy connection.
So Walmart was my first like good paying job. I guess it wasn't even that great paying.
But it was a paying.
It was a paying job. And I remember my first ever purchase was the black cat fours.
Nice.
And I remember exactly like the day it happened too. So I dropped my mom off to work at 8 o'clock in the morning because she worked at Walmart as well. The mall wasn't open yet. The mall opened at 9:30. So I just chilled around, had breakfast at McDonald's because I was a fat kid. And then waited around because I knew the shoe was dropping that day. And Foot Locker opened its doors. It was literally like maybe two people, no lineup. I was the only customer. There was like two associates. I walk in. He's like, "Hey, man, what are you looking for?" I was like, the black cat fours. He's like, "What size?" I was like, 11. And then he's like, "Yo, do you want to try them on?" I'm like, "I can try them on." He's like, "Yeah." And that was it, man. It was like the easiest purchase ever.
Good old days.
Yeah. And then the week after, I bought the Cardinal Sevens. A week after that.
Oh, God.
Oh, my Lord.
So it started off with Jordans. And then the homie Sonny Lozano took me to a spot called Boredom.
Mm-hmm.
And then wifey bought me, shout out to Sasha Mello Martinez. She always wanted me to shout her out on a podcast.
Shout out.
What up, boo boo?
My sister-in-law.
She bought me two pairs of SB Blazers. And that's what got me on the SB craze for a bit.
Clutch.
So sick.
Yeah, so she bought me the Biotech Blazers, and she bought me the, I think we called it the Baroque Brown or like the barbecue Blazers.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Those two. And after that, I was on like a Blazer or like Blazer and Dunk copying spree for a bit. Yeah.
You're already answering my next question, which was your evolution of sneakers.
Oh, okay.
So keep going.
So Jordan, SB, Blazer, SB Dunk. And then I found this store online called Designer Shoe Athletics where I bought two dope pairs of Dunks.
You sure those were authentic?
Yeah, they were. Because I looked, I did my research, man. I'm not like these kids who don't do their fucking research.
Yikes.
I do my research and I get my shit, make sure it's legit. I don't do no legit check shit. Like, what the fuck is that?
You do your own legit checks.
And then after that, I was on like a serious Jordan copying spree. And then obviously Air Max. And now my shoe closet consists of Air Jordan 1s, 4s, 3s, 11s, a bunch of Air Maxes, some New Balances, and like a couple of Sauconys. And
that's quite diverse.
Yeah. Hirachis too. I got a bunch of Hirachis. I love Hirachis.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
I know that one.
And that's it, man.
Keep Mr. Q-Mart's evolution of sneakers in mind for my origin story.
it's the exact same story.
No, not even. Super opposite. All right. Favorite silhouette?
Fuck. I mean, if I had to pick one to wear for the rest of my life, probably the Jordan 1.
Mm. Easy choice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the Jordan 1. You can really just rock it with anything. Like, you're good to go. Like, if I was allowed to wear it to work, you already know I would wear that to work every fucking day.
Yep.
Every single color I would have, I would rock it to work. But that's not the circumstance at the moment. Hopefully in the future, we'll see. Mm-hmm. But yeah, man, Air Jordan 1.
Okay, so what keeps you into sneakers?
I honestly think it's an addiction. I think I'm addicted to the hunt.
The cop.
And just
the feeling.
Whenever I don't purchase a pair of sneakers for a while, I get the itch, you know, like, mm-hmm. I start looking for something to cop or
fill the void in my room.
Yeah. And then like Joel said last week, it's like these brands always end up coming out with either bringing back colorways that I never had or, you know, just coming out with some new stuff. And that's it, man. It's the hunt for me. And just right now, I think I'm filtering it and I just want my grails. So, I mean, we'll see what happens. Obviously, money's a situation, but
yeah,
you know, we'll work around it.
I feel like we're all hitting that phase now.
Yeah.
Grails only phase.
I'm quite inspired by Lawrence Hopkins at the moment with his grail hunting mentality at the moment.
Fuck the rest, man.
Trust.
If you're not gonna care about it in 2 years, it doesn't matter right now.
Yeah, that's my new purchasing philosophy. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's pretty crucial. Speaking of purchasing, would you guys buy and this is gonna start the new segment. This Week in Kicks. the Yeezy 6 Desert Rat boot.
No, I don't like Ooh? That.
Have you seen
I've
it?
I've never seen it.
What is it?
Oh,
Desert Rat?
Yeah.
It's the color of a desert rat.
It's like you've seen the Wave Runner, right? No, that's not the Wave Runner. That's the 700.
Yeah, it's like the it's not the
it's like a military kind.
Yeah, but almost. Like, I don't know. I'm not a fan.
I wish I had a picture of it.
The 700 is cute though.
I like the 700. Yeah, I like the original color of the 700 for sure.
It's just not a grail thing, you know.
No, exactly.
Or you know his other dad shoe, and it kind of looks like the questions.
The low cut.
Like and underneath it's like bubbly.
Oh, yeah.
There's like a ton of circles. So it's that, except it's got like a boot higher, cut now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not a huge fan of that.
So no.
It's going to be a no for me. Yeah.
Yeah, me too. No cop. It's, I was quite astonished when the guy at work showed it to me today and he was like, have you seen these? I was like, I don't want to see them. I'm okay. But I do want to see and buy the Fila X Pokemon Kicks.
I saw those.
What? I am super sad. They're only kids.
That's what I thought. Yeah,
and it's only Korea right now.
Oh man,
I'm super bummed.
Kaya would rock those.
Trust and
there
Christine.
You go.
I want to get Christine a pair. Christine, my wife. She's
sweet.
If there's like GS sizes, and they make their way over to stateside, maybe I can swing something.
Swoop.
Hopefully, if she likes something, I got a cop.
It's one of those.
That's easy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. Like she was looking at the Wotherspoons with me at work today. Yeah, spoiler alert, I work with her. I'm like, would you rock these? And she's like, I like them. I'm like, you doomed yourself. You doomed yourself. It's the colors, man.
Yeah, it's all the colors.
It's the
and
colors.
Materials too.
They're so dope.
Even just the shape of the shoe itself. Like a 97 is really like heavily liked by females.
Yeah. No, it's
wavy.
It
doesn't surprise me. But what does surprise me is Nike Sherway's opening. Dang.
I heard that.
See that segue, though?
Mm-hmm.
you guys can't see it, but I rolled my eyes.
Have they been open for so long?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, they've been open. What the hell?
I had no idea, though.
No, bro, from time.
Because I there was barely any talks of it amongst us, at least. They're amongst even homies.
No one told Alan, so it means it just happened.
Yeah.
A couple months.
Essentially.
Essentially. A couple months?
Mm-hmm. It's been a while,
I was there when there was still a lot of snow on the ground.
Super awkward. I literally just saw like a storefront picture of it today from one of my homies.
It's cute.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It looks pretty dope.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing I found out today was the Artists of Air event that's happening on Air Max Day in Toronto.
Yeah.
They're like taking four local artists and they're going to have their rendition. Kind of like how they had it for us last year, where they got to pick like their favorite Air Max silhouette and do a little...
Oh, like the room, that Sneakeasy? Yeah,
Sneakeasy. Yeah. That was the name of the event. I was trying to remember it. But yeah, I think they're going to do something like that again.
Nice.
In Toronto. I can't remember the location.
It's at Spoke Club on King Street.
Thank you, Lawrence.
Oh, there you go.
Open to public from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m.
Yeah.
Nice.
Ooh.
Yeah. That sounds pretty cool. I can't make it, though, because I finish work at 5:30, and I'd get downtown by 7.
Word.
Super unfortunate. Word. Oh, you can probably make it, Alvin.
Hey, you'll be down there already, I'm sure.
We'll see what happens.
Lawrence, you too, maybe?
Maybe. We'll see. I'm off that day, but I don't know if I'm going to spend the whole day downtown or not. We'll see.
True.
Are you going into Canada Got Sold to find out?
Are you going to line up for the Wotherspoons that day?
I'm not sure yet. If it's cold, no. If it's warm, yes.
Is it all raffle or no? Some of them are first come, first serve.
I think the only place that's announced a raffle so far is Livestock.
Okay.
Everywhere else, I'm assuming, because I was checking on Nike.ca and Exclusivity are getting it, Capsule, and also Haven.
Yes.
And they haven't announced a raffle yet, so I'm going to assume first come, first serve, because the raffle would have probably started by now.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Did you guys hear about the Finnish store in Finland called Beam Hill, I believe? Mm-mm. And the only way to have a chance to get a pair of the Wotherspoons is to write a short story about your love for Air Maxes, and you title it Air Max and I, and they're gonna, I guess, judge it and stuff.
You have to send it into them?
Yeah.
Holy smokes.
That sounds so cool, though.
Wow.
Yeah.
Can anyone enter?
I think it's local only or Finland only.
I'm so good at essays.
Yeah, we would write the dopest short stories.
Oh, my God.
We'd have it on our blogs. We could, like, two for one that.
That's pretty cool. I like that. I like all the creative ways that stores are getting people their shoes nowadays. It's cool. Mm-hmm. Instead of just basic raffles and lineups. Mm-hmm. It's cool. I like it.
Yeah, and it says here, the main emphasis will be on context more than the language or grammar.
Sweet.
Feel free to interpret the subject as creatively as you want. That's amazing.
That's
pretty cool. Yeah.
So you it's literally just a love letter. Mm-hmm. For how much you love Air
and
Maxes.
If you're not good at essays, you're not going to be penalized, which is good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty amazing.
My typos would be okay then.
There you go. Yeah.
Grammar.
Even Alvin would be okay.
Mm-hmm.
What? Disappointing though, because I found out that they're not dropping on Nike.ca anymore.
Yeah, they pulled it.
Apparently, it has something to do with like the demand for it.
I just heard that they want them to be all in store, like as accessible as possible in stores on Air Max Day.
Nice.
I think that's the idea.
Mm. True.
They're just going to allocate everything to
stores, I guess. Nice. I'm still wondering if the Nike stores are going to get, like you mentioned, Sherway. I'm wondering if like those stores are going to get it, even like Eaton Center, because they've gotten some T-Zero stuff before. Like they got Air Max 1-6. They got the Safari Furry Atmos a couple years ago.
Or shops like Nordstrom, they could get the women pairs.
Well, they got the women's 95s.
That's crazy. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's pretty dope.
So it's not impossible. We'll see. I like it, though. Make it more accessible, as accessible as possible for everybody.
Facts. Especially locally. And it helps to promote your local movements.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, especially since they're pushing the Nike Toronto thing so much. Yeah. Like, it's great that they can allocate more pairs to the city so people can actually get them and wear them in the city.
And then you have to pick them up that day, or people who go line up that day. There's that dope event in Toronto that day.
There you go. You that can day. Swing by that go. Day.
That sounds pretty cool.
That day.
Oh, nice. I like it. Did you guys hear about the Concorde 11s and how many units they're planning to produce?
1 million.
Over. Wow.
True.
That's not surprising, though.
No?
I'm not surprised.
No.
So
no?
Restocks.
Space Jams, all the 11s I can think of in the past long while have been huge GRs.
It's going to be the most produced.
Oh, yeah? They said that?
Ever, I believe. Oh. Yeah.
True.
It's not surprising.
I read
it
somewhere.
Kill it. Go ahead. Make everyone get a pair.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. People love that shoe. Make sure everyone gets a pair.
Mm-hmm.
I do want one. Although I wore... Oh, that's what I wore today. 11s.
What?
No one cares anymore. They're past that.
I wore the Winlike 89s.
Mm. 82.
82s.
It's 82.
My bad. What? Is it 82?
Is that the red one?
86? No, Winlike 96, Winlike 82. Yeah, 82.
Okay. 82.
82 is the navy one.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, 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 yes. Oh, yeah. My bad. I'm an idiot. Apologies. Yo, off that. I'm sick. I'm sick. I'm sick. I'm sick. I'm sick. I was looking down at my feet today, and I don't know if I, like, am that on about 11s anymore.
I'm just not a huge fan of that higher cut patent leather.
Yeah, I think that's what was throwing me off too.
Clunkier to me. It's a lot clunkier look. Mm. Like, I know it's for the sure. OG look, but I mean, but that doesn't always mean it's better.
Some people have complained it to the OG ones and noticed that it is a little bit too high. But
it is closer, I think, than like the more recent ones. Yeah. But everyone thinks that because it's OG, it has to be better. Like,
yeah. No, I remember seeing Alvin's 11s growing up and stuff. While I was into comic books, and the patent leather was a much sleeker shape.
Yeah, it makes the shoe look less clunky.
And it literally doesn't look like a wall.
Yeah, there's a huge panel of patent leather that's all you see. Yeah.
Yeah. I saw a article on Soul Collector, and it talked about Tinker Hatfield and his relationship with Justin Timberlake.
Ooh.
Please tell me more.
Yeah, it's pretty sick. This is going to excite you.
Already excited.
The first line, however, bothered me a little bit, and it read, "It was a sneaker collab that was equal parts surprising and confusing."
Hmm?
Who was confused?
The writer.
You were confused to text me.
Yeah, I don't get it. Well, we talked about it last episode already, about how he's already had a collaboration with Jordan Brand.
Yeah, he's been there,
bro. He's already had that relationship with them. So that's why I was bothered by it. But moving along. Tinker Hatfield goes to say, "The reality is that we are looking at ways to interact and collaborate with different kinds of influencers. Athletes, of course, are still going to be big for us, but entertainers are mingling in and out of sports culture and music culture and all of that." He then goes on to say, and Lawrence, this is exciting.
I'm already hard.
Oh my God. He says, "I've found Justin to be a very fun guy, and he's really easy to talk to. Us too. Dad, what's up, Pops? I actually have an idea that he doesn't know about, and at some point, I hope that we do get together for another project."
Oh, shit.
Yep.
That he doesn't know about.
Yeah, he doesn't know about it yet because he's busy being Justin Timberlake, but I do hope that there are other entertainers and athletes and people other than designers and artists and everything else that we can continue to weave into our process.
I agree, for sure.
Yeah, man.
That's great. I love that they do that.
Nowadays, it's just been all about collaborations and jumping people in.
All you've heard for the past friggin' year and a half is Off-White. Like,
Off-White.
All you've heard is Off-White this, Off-White that. Every blog, everyone posting about Off-White and Virgil. And it's a great collection, but, like, expand. Like, come on. Like, expand your breadth. Like, show them. It's Nike. It's Jordan. Like, they have so much more potential than just, like, four different VaporMaxes with Virgil. Like, great collaboration. Yeah, great collaboration.
Yeah, that, come on. I think that's what bothers me the most is it's the same silhouettes.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, I mean, like I said, they're still great looking shoes. Like, I would still wear them all. I wouldn't, like, not take one, but I don't know.
Yeah.
I just want to see some different stuff. I get bored so easily. Like, I have, like, friggin' just, like, I can't stay put. I need to see different things. Like, a swoosh on a three is like, whoa, cool. And now I'm like, what's next after that? A swoosh on a four? Like, I want to see more. That.
Speaking of the swoosh on the three, I read a comment earlier this week about exactly that. Just Tinker Hatfield's original sketches and designs, like the Air Max Zero and stuff like that. Oh, it's not a comment. I actually heard it in a conversation. I was talking to someone. But do you guys think that those stories are legit, or if it's great marketing?
No, it's definitely legit. No way. Definitely. Don't even. No, it's definitely legit.
I want to get Joel's opinion on this.
I don't know. Like, hard, man. I know, like, is there, like, legit blueprint?
I swear they have actual sketches. Yeah, I swear. I mean, you can't legit check a sketch either, I guess. But
yeah,
like,
and the date. That's right. That's what gets me, like, I don't know.
But I read a whole story about, like, the whole swoosh on the three. Like, there's no way they fabricated a whole... Now you're making me question my whole world. That, like, that, don't even...
No, that's what I mean,
next
though.
Next question.
Like, that's what I mean, though. Because, well, you can't even, like, shit on Nike for this because their marketing has been on point since
the
end of time. Like, and until the end of time, it's going to be crazy. But, yeah, it opened up a door in my head to make me think about, who knows...
Just all bullshit.
What if?
Yeah.
What if?
Right.
Yeah.
But like at some point, as much as that story is awesome, like, I liked the JTH and the Tinker before I read the story.
Trust me.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if anyone's buying it just for the story. I'm sure there's some people who are story fiends and they just only bought it for the story, but the masses are probably buying it for the aesthetic.
We are.
So, to some extent, like, it makes me want it more.
Yeah.
But a Justin Timberlake Jordan 3 doesn't need a story attached to it.
It's like the free throw line.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I guess it's comparable to that.
I agree. Yeah.
Yeah. They're just making stories out of it.
People would have bought the White Cement 3 with a red line, whether it was there was a story or not.
A White Cement 3.
Yeah, it's a White Cement 3.
Blue Icy outsole. As much as people complained about the Blue Icy outsole.
Sold out. Sells for $5 now.
Yeah. Yep. Trust me. So, Joel, was it you that mentioned Black Cement 4s?
No.
Or was it Alvin?
Maybe it was Alvin.
I don't know. I'm sick. Did you guys see Scollard's post earlier today?
Yeah, he posted the picture we talked about.
Yeah, so Sean Collard, our homie, Scollard23 on Instagram.
At Scollard23.
Yeah. Did you read the story that went along with it?
I was driving when he posted that, so I shouldn't have even seen it.
Okay, so...
didn't read the caption.
I didn't see it.
I just wanted to talk about it real quick. Not too long, because I already know our thoughts on this. But he told the story. It was like a couple hours ago he posted it. And it was about something that his wife overheard at Soul Exchange Canada. I think you already know where this is going. Alvin feels strongly about this. A kid pointed to his OG4s, nudged his homie, and said... he wore them, followed up with an eye roll. Like Sean, I interpreted this as the kid thinking that these shoes could be worth so much more had he not worn them. Yeah.
The kids are wastemans,
isn't it? Yeah, it just blows my mind. Just because, especially being someone who hasn't really been into kicks for as long as you guys, it actually hurts me because like the passion and like the heart that goes behind being quote unquote a sneakerhead or a sneaker lover, it's like, it's not there. And nowadays it's just all about, and we talked about it last week, it's all about reselling and having things at the highest value in your collection.
Yeah. People just want to know what's the highest, what's the shoe that you have that's worth the most.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And like, it blows my mind.
Fuck.
And I thought about it too. And I believe that is also why I got over my Yeezys and I sold them that fast. Yeah. Other than the fact that I wanted them for the JTHs.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But what came across my mind was this, it's that the Yeezy to me nowadays, it's a shoe that anyone can have and think they have a collection or they have fire. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. I know what you mean. It's what it represents now. Like it's, yeah. Everyone who thinks they have the sickest collection is because they have 3, 4, or 5 pairs of Yeezy 350 Boosts that came out in the past 2 years. Like, if that's what you like, that's a different story.
Bar, yes.
Good for you. But if you're buying it because you see everyone else wearing it and then you know it's worth this much and like whatever, like, no, I don't fuck with it.
Even to I hate being like a douchebag about this and like confession time because I always feel this way sometimes, but new sneakerheads. Oh my god, I need a Yeezy. And when they get the Yeezys, yo, I got so much heat.
Yeah.
Fuck with me.
Yeah.
Get out of here. Anyways, on to better things.
Alan's just a hater, everybody. If you like Yeezys, keep your Yeezys, everybody. All you listeners out there with Yeezys. I have Yeezys. Fuck Alan. What does he know? He doesn't own any Yeezys.
Wow. Not anymore.
He's mad because he doesn't own any Yeezys.
No, it's fine. Which leads me to the next segment. Alan gets JTHs. Fuck yeah, I did.
Yeah, he did.
I'm super excited. I got a box, and it has a signature on it.
Tell us the story. Tell us the story. The people want to know.
There's not really much to it.
This is the longest running segment in this show. We need to know the story.
I was just checking out the Facebook groups. Lawrence egged me on to like put a post out there that I wanted to buy a pair.
Well, now it's my fault. Okay, great.
No, it's not your fault.
Christine, it wasn't my fault. He wanted it before I said
anything.
Listen,
Christine was supportive of it, so don't worry about that.
There we go. Nice. That's all that matters.
Yeah, that's the best part. So I was looking, and I just wanted to see the prices. Like, I just wanted to see what was going on and what people were posting it for. And you had told me days before this that, like, signed pairs were going for, like, stacks.
Yeah, like, actual signed on the shoe. People were telling me they're going for, like, racks on racks on racks. Yeah.
So, like, I knew that having a signature on it was going to be something that I wanted to have in the first place. I knew that I wasn't going to be able to afford the ones with like where it's on the actual shoe.
But if that's your first pair, like for me, like if that was my first one, I wouldn't want it to have a signature because I want to wear the shoe.
Yeah.
Then you have to buy two. Like,
that's the best part. So like I was looking and looking and I stumbled upon a post and it was a size 9 and it was signed but on the box. And they were DS.
Which is perfect.
Nice.
And I had it for a really reasonable price for the fact that there's the signature. On
Yeah, you got a really box. Good deal. Mm-hmm. Like, not too much over what people are asking for. Yeah. No signature whatsoever. Yeah.
So I offered him. Low-key, I lowballed him. And he, shout out to, should I say his name?
Yeah, he sold them to you. Why not?
No, sure. It's okay.
No one listens to the show anyways.
Wow. What was his last name, Lawrence?
Gerard Joseph is his name.
Gerard Joseph.
Shouts to Gerard Joseph.
Shout out Gerard Joseph. So he had it posted. I lowballed him. And he legit was a nice guy. He's like, nah, man, I can't do that. He was just super cool. And I was like, ah, oh, thanks for not being a dick. And he's like, nah, life's too short for just being a dick to anyone. And I'm like, wow, that's facts. You're super cool. So then I just got to talking to him. We just started a conversation. And then I mentioned how I hit up Lawrence about it. And he's like, oh, yeah, I know that guy. And then I mentioned it to Gerard that Lawrence knows him. And he's like, he's the homie. And I'm like, yeah, he's like a brother to me. And then out of nowhere, like after like 5 minutes of silence, he just goes, so meet up tonight? And I was like,
you're welcome.
I can't do tonight. Yeah.
To both of you.
Oh, I know, right? You helped both of us out. Thanks, Lawrence. So yeah, I met up with him the day after in Toronto. And he handed me the pair of shoes. We had the same shoes on. Shout out Black Cement 3s.
Nice. Bringing people together.
Yeah, it's so funny. Christine came with me. She was my bodyguard. Super cool dude, Gerard. You're a real one. Thank you very much.
Yeah, if anyone here doesn't know who Gerard is, you should follow him first of all on Instagram.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure it's at Gerard Joseph, but he's been killing it lately.
Gerard X Joseph.
Yeah, on Instagram, he shoots like some unreal photography, and he shoots like stuff that gets posted on Complex, Hypebeast. Like, he's way up there.
Yep.
Yeah. He had a random class with him at York like years ago.
Yeah, that's super what he said. Funny. That's when I talked to him in person. I asked about how you guys met each other, and he's like, we had a class together.
Gender and the law.
Oh, man. Okay. Now that we're in better moods, let's stay in better moods. Wow, sorry for all of the coughing and the sniffling and stuff like that that's happening in this podcast and the last podcast.
Yeah.
But we're going to do another segment called Letter Time. And this is from our listeners who gave us a bit of feedback, the past few days.
Letter Time!
From episode 2. Maybe we should make some jingles. Bram.
It's Letter
Bram,
Time!
Bram, where you at? Let's get some theme songs for these segments. One of our listeners said, love the podcast, guys. Want to hear your thoughts and opinions on all these brands collaborations we are seeing now, like the Off-White Nike, OVO Jordan, Supreme Nike, and Adidas, Bape, etc. This is from our homie Jarek Presto.
Hello, Jarek Presto. Oh, I also love the podcast.
Oh, I know that guy. What up, bruh?
We all love the podcast. That's good. He's in with us already.
Awesome. Something thoughts, in common.
Thoughts on all the collabs.
Do you think it's being too saturated?
It's getting there. It's almost getting too much. Yeah. Like, so many people are not buying anything unless it's a collaboration now, and I don't think that's the best.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think it's just part of the culture now and we should accept it, or
no? Don't accept anything if you don't like it. Don't just it's all fine. No, don't get used to something if you don't want to.
Okay.
Like, even if you look at this month, like, the two biggest releases for Air Max month are what? Atmos and Sean's. They're collabs.
Yeah.
Like, why does it have to be like that? Like, last year they had Masters. Masters are an OG color silhouette, whatever. That thing bumped. Like, that shoe was unreal.
Yeah.
Mm. Like, I feel like it's great that Nike, Adidas, all these brands are outsourcing for different opinions and different styles and different looks. But we know that they got it. Like, we know they can do it. And I just feel like it's lazy at some point if they just result or let other people do it instead of them.
Mm.
Facts. Yeah, no, I thought about it well and hard. And I really want brands to start, like, I guess, challenging themselves to, like, come out with more original pieces and more different colorways and stuff like that. I guess that's part of why they're making these stories and new sketches for Jumpman, just so they do come out with new and original content, and it's not just retros on retros on retros.
Like, it used to be a collab with something special. Like, it wasn't that often. Yes. Like, look at, like, when Fragment Ones came out. Like, when was the, like, a time around then when another Jordan had a collab with it?
Dog, not even that. Like, when Nike SB used to do collabs.
Yeah, like, it wasn't every single silhouette was a collab. It was, like, tons of killer like GRs that everyone still wanted, and then a collab comes out and you're like, there it is, like that's when it's like pops off. But like,
I think what bothers me now that I think about it, is like the collabs are coming from, as much as I love my GTHs, celebrities, as opposed to how it used to be with like skate shops,
stores, and stuff like that. Skaters. I could see that.
Like real heads, themselves. Legit heads who pour their heart and soul out into this stuff and like can dream up a shoe in their favorite silhouettes and their like favorite colorways and stuff like that.
A lot of these people they're collaborating with though are like very immersed in the culture. Like you talk about JT, like he's been wearing Jordans. Like every picture I've seen of him for the past 10 years, he's had a pair of Jordans on. Like he might not have the most creative, I don't know if he has the most creative mind, like some of these skate shop owners who have been skating for their entire life and they've seen every single skate shoe from every brand, but like it's still, I don't know. I don't even know, man. It's a lot of collabs. It's overwhelming at times. Everything is a collab now. Yeah,
there's a lot of collaborations going on.
Joel, what was the first collab you ever saw like coming up with your sneakers? Was it Supreme SB?
Yeah, it was the Supreme SB.
Like the first ones?
The highs. The
first ones.
No, the lows.
The lows.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Where you been?
The black cement lows.
Sleeping.
Black and white?
Yeah, it's probably those Supremes. And then, you know, going into like Air Maxes and stuff like that, you had like the Bren Drurys, right? And then, you know, Atmos, obviously. But it's just basically shops and like with the Bren Drurys that just went out of nowhere, like a radio host.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
What?
And it just, I don't know, it's just like stuff like that they need to get back on. Like going back like to like the stories, like you know what I mean? Yeah, like the out of nowheres or like something with history behind like the shoe kind of thing.
Oh,
right?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I hear that.
You know? Love that though. That's what keeps me in it. Like the stories and
that's
like,
what it
all
is.
That.
Right?
Like I love that. Just like shit. With I eat it up.
Going back to Sean Scollard, like his stuff is just crazy and you know, like the stories that went behind each shoe that he had on his table at Soul Exchange.
Facts.
It was just like phenomenal. And it's still like, look, we're still even talking about it till now.
Yeah.
Oh, I know. You know what I mean? One episode later.
Yeah.
Shout out to Sean Collard.
Yeah, man. Shout out to Sean.
What do you think, Alvin? Too many collabs or nah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, from the latest Off-White collab, I'm like, in my head, I'm like, yo, they look dope, but again?
That's what I mean, yeah.
Again?
Yeah.
How many fucking Off-Whites do you fucking need?
And at the same time, too, it's not just Nike and Off-White who are blowing it up. It's like you see it on your feed endlessly. Like every, like you don't see Complex or Soul Collector posting GRs or this or that.
Yeah.
All you see is Off-White this, Off-White that, Bape this, Supreme that, and it just gets shoved down your throat until it comes out. Like how long did we have to look at the 10 collection before it came out? And now even after it's out, that's all we see.
Yeah.
Like there's so much other stuff out there, and I feel like that's all that we get exposed to with like the media outlets. They just shove it down your throat, and I'm sure Nike plays a part in it. Like they know what's selling,
marketing.
And they know what they want people to push. But at the same time, like you can only see so many Off-White ones before you're like, okay, I know what it looks like now.
Yeah. And then it pushes other brands to do the exact same thing as well.
Yeah, it's just a cycle at that point. Yeah.
Oh, this is what's in. Cool. Let's do it.
Yeah.
I guess it goes back to our conversation last week about Adidas and just sticking to what's currently in trends and such.
Yeah, they have a lot. Adidas has a lot of collabs. And some of them are great. Like, some of them are great looking shoes. Like, those Bape Dames that dropped during All-Star, I loved that shoe. Because to me, that was out of nowhere.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like, what is Bape, Damian Lillard, and Adidas? Like, how are they even connected? And all of a sudden, like, they...
Pharrell.
Oh, yeah?
Well, if you think about it, Pharrell's been working with Bape since time.
But Damian Lillard.
Yeah, but Adidas.
That's what I mean. No, that's what I mean, though. It could have been on anything.
Yeah.
And it could have been on a Harden. But it was a Dame.
True.
Like, that's what I mean. Like, why those three? To me, that's, like, so out of nowhere, and I love that.
Mm. Very true.
Or, like, undefeated Kobe Proto 1s. Like, that's
Proto?
Or whatever it is. Yeah, like, those are the kind of things where it's like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Like, that's out of nowhere. Those are awesome. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I love Undefeated's collabs with Nike.
Oh, yeah. They kill it. They kill it. Yeah.
And so many of them are, like, sleepers.
Mm-hmm.
So good.
And they come out of nowhere.
Yeah, exactly.
Come out of nowhere is my favorite.
Literally.
Wasn't that a tagline for Nike last year?
Yeah, it was.
For DeMar DeRozan?
Yeah, it was.
Hey, shout out to DeMar DeRozan. He's killing it.
The same shit happened at ComplexCon. Like, remember the week leading up to ComplexCon?
Oh,
my God. It was like every single day. It was like, there's an undefeated 97. There's an NERD human race. There's a this, yeah, there's a that. Like, it was just like, it was sick because it's so out of nowhere. Like, I love those out of nowhere. Like,
only releasing at ComplexCon.
Or even the JTH. Like, it's just like, bam, it releases in 5 hours. Like, to me, that's dope. Like, you can do that all day and I'd be happy. But it's when I see it every day for a year, I'm just so over it.
It makes things feel like unicorns and it makes sneakers feel special.
And they have a story.
Yeah.
Because you remember where you were when you saw that JTH post. And then you remember everyone going down and you remember him showing up. Like, those are stories you remember forever. Mm-hmm. And I love that shit, man.
Alvin, Joel, when you guys, like, started collecting your sneakers, especially when SB Dunks, they always had quick strikes. For those that don't know, quick strikes is just something that, like, Nike will announce exactly what was Lawrence was talking about, where they'll announce a shoe and then it'll drop within, like, a week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of an announcement. Did you guys ever like have those moments where you find out about a shoe and then you just rush to the store to go figure out if it's still going to be there or not? Or you called in and...
Well, actually,
Joel's
I don't know.
Joel's face has a story.
I know. I love it.
That's story time.
Nike Talk, right? Mm-hmm. You would go on Nike Talk. You would read the forums and you'd be like, you know, there's always like an SB forum in Canada. Mm-hmm. And then you would like search like, you know, Toronto or Mississauga and it would come up and all these stories, all these heads, they would type out, they would post up where to find SBs, right? And then you can even post up, look, I'm in the Lakeshore area. Where can I find SBs close to me? And then boom, somebody will hit you up. But like, yo, there's a shop by like, you know, here Ontario and Lakeshore. Mm-hmm. You know, go check it out. It's like behind an alley on the side door. You walk in, boom, they have like, you know, the Irish, the Irish.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They had those sitting there. That's where I picked up my Brian Andersons.
Oh.
They were sitting there. The you know what I mean? The highs.
The BA high, yeah.
That's where they had them there. That's where I picked up the Brian. But that's how we looked. That's how we found out. Like there was no social media back then. Our social media was like on dial up. Going on to Nike Talk, you know, logging into Youku, logging into like, you know, ISS forums and finding out, you know, where to go get these shoes. Like back then we just had like boutiques like Goodfoot and Livestock and then, you know, obviously the Stolen Riches and the Zone would pop up and you know, those were like the shops that we had. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like I would go
RIP.
Yeah, so I would go to Goodfoot, right? When I first started dating Marianne, we would go there, we'd just hang out. I wouldn't buy no shoes. I would just hang out and shoot the shit.
Yeah.
I'd be like, you know, I'd be there. I'd be like talking to my man Q, you know, shout out to Q, the Dynamics, on Instagram. But, we would just shoot the shit for like hours and we would just talk and talk and talk. And then, you know, customers would come in like, yo, what's up? You know, and then we just talk and that's how it was back then. Like, I remember when my son was born, we would push the stroller into Goodfoot and, you know, just talk, like, let him, like, you know, walk around and whatever. But, you know, that's how it was back in the day. Like when we were in the game.
Yeah.
If you want to call it.
That's
so
sick.
Yeah, it's definitely different now. That's
much different now.
Like, yeah.
That's so sick. If we had a YouTube video going on with this podcast, all you would see is me looking at Joel with a big smile on my face. That made me so happy.
But that's how it was. That's how it all was back then.
Okay.
And now you know about it years in advance.
Now you know about it.
Yeah,
you know
about it. Seriously.
Like, we know everything's coming out until like 2042. Like, yeah. It's crazy now.
Bonkers. Okay. You know how I just gave the definition of quick strike?
Yes.
Yeah.
We're going to play a quick game.
Wait, I have a question.
Let's go for it.
I feel like it's for you mostly.
Oh.
You know how on some Nike sportswear releases?
Yeah.
Air Yeezy 2 NRG?
Yeah.
Anyone know what the fuck NRG means?
What is just NRG?
I checked everything. I have no idea. Because someone asked me and I was like, wait, I have no idea what that actually means.
I don't know. I think it's another rollout just for like another category for Nike. It's just energy.
But it doesn't stand for anything?
I'm not exactly sure what it stands for.
Because like I can think of like Galaxy Foams had it. Yeezy 2's had it. So I know it's like sportswear related.
I can find out. I can look into it.
Okay. And next week. Tune in next
week. I mean, it's even Jordan has it. The Tinkers.
That's true. Yeah, they had NRG as well. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. This is sick. Abbreviations. Ready? This is the next comment that we got from actually Mr. Q Martin, mine's sister, Alyssa. Shout out to you. She says, as a sneaker noob, it would be cool to hear what tips you guys have to learn more, like the basics, to get someone started. So, I've compiled a quick list of a glossary. Mm. Lawrence.
Yeah.
Care to explain what DS is?
DS, better known as deadstock, is a pair of shoes that has never been worn. Still factory. Never been worn. We'll just never say been never worn. Been yeah. worn. Yeah.
Leave it at that.
And then you have variations of VNDS, which would be very near dead stock. So you've worn it a couple times, and it still looks pretty new. But dead stock, I think the broadest definition you could give would be brand new, never worn. Yeah.
Okay.
Final answer.
Alvin, do you want to do UNDS?
Yeah. To UNDS. This, my friends, refers to the act of wearing your fucking shoes.
Jesus.
Never heard of it.
I did not know it was going to go in that
direction.
That means, my friends.
Sir.
This act of undressing means to place your sneaker on thy foot.
Thy foot.
And wear it outside.
So it'd have to be outside.
Oh, yes. I wanted to ask you guys, if it's tried on, is it still DS?
No.
Very near dead.
Brand new. Brand new tried on.
VVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVVV
contrary to popular belief. Contrary to popular belief.
Grief.
It gives me grief when I hear this. Your grail did not come out last week.
Oh, shit.
Most likely.
Yeah, it came out yesterday.
A lot of people's grails I see on these groups and whatever are Yeezys that haven't come out yet, or
this
Jordan
is a definition, not a rant, bro.
No, it's a rant. Or these bread toes are some people's grails. That's nice to me, which is the right answer. A grail.
Can I say the JTHs are one of my grails?
No, because I'm about to explain why.
Okay, right.
A grail is something you have coveted for a long period of time. Or something you may own that has been in your collection for a long period of time, that has been at the top of your list for longer than a week, Alvin.
I don't know if I agree with that, but okay.
I don't care. You ask me.
Hold on. I'm moving my mic around because I want to debate real quick.
Oh, God.
I would say that for me, a grail is one of your definitions. Your definition is like on point
also
as well.
Also correct.
For sure.
Yes.
But it's a shoe that I would not be able to part with. One, either it's because of sentimental reasons.
I like that.
Or it's just that shoe.
I agree. I'm not going to debate you. I don't need to adjust my mic.
But, why is there so much sass?
Because we like sass.
I feel like that has to be attached to what I said also.
I think it is.
It can't just be a
but
shoe
I don't
that
know if you're allowed to
part with.
But I don't know if you're allowed to have a time stamp on it, though.
I do. I think so. Personally, I don't think a grail is something. Like, to me, a grail is like all time, like favorite, like
no,
this is incredible.
No, I totally
like,
hear what you mean.
Like, I don't sure. think something can gain that much traction in your mind or in your collection after a month.
Yeah,
it can definitely be. It can definitely catapult itself to your top five. Yeah. But like,
so
there's
to
no
you,
way.
Grail, a grail is so heartfelt.
Yeah, there's so much more to it than okay. just like, yeah, I like these a lot still.
Joel, what are your thoughts? I need to hear from you.
Me, a grail is
fight me.
Something you've always wanted to get.
Okay, so there's time. Yeah, but okay, I hear you.
You cannot get it.
Acquire it.
You okay. cannot acquire it.
Or it's taken forever too.
Yeah. Right. Like for me it's the Amsterdams. That's my grail.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
Yeah. If I can get that, I can
Amsterdam Air Max 1s.
I can Air Max 1s. If I can get those, that's it. I'm done.
And to me too, like
right. So
a lot of these shoes, like I've been doing grail copying in the past 2 years. I don't know if I consider it a grail. Once I acquire it, like, do you feel the same way, Joel? Like, once you get it, is it still a grail or does it have a different title attached to it? Is a grail something that you don't have? Like, the Holy Grail, I didn't read the Bible. I don't even know that's in the Bible.
It is.
Okay. But, like, is it something this guy was after and then once he got it, or was it something that he already had? Because to me, it's something you're chasing. And then when you get it, it could be number one in your collection, but is it a grail? I don't know. What do you guys think? Let us know in our Canada Got Soul DM on Instagram.
Or comment on the YouTube.
Or comment. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Comment, yeah, that works. Subscribe, like.
No, how would you define grail?
It's so crazy because like, I've had that. I can literally feel it still about how I got through like the JTH thing.
Yeah.
Mm. You know what I mean? Ever since the Super Bowl, you know how bad like we wanted
yeah,
it, right?
Both of us, yeah.
And then I saw you get your second pair, and like I wanted it even more. And now that I have it, it's kind of like,
Your shoulders drop, and then it's on to the next one. Like that's how collecting should be. It shouldn't be your shoulders stay up because there's something else coming out, and then you sell the one you got, and then your shoulders drop, and then you buy another one. Like no,
okay. So moving along, highs, mids, lows. That refers to the cut of the shoe.
Mm-hmm.
High cut, low cut, mid cut, obvious. Alvin, your favorite type of people? Reseller.
Huh?
Define reseller.
Define reseller.
Yeah, do it.
An individual who waits in line.
We have friends who are resellers, so be careful.
No, I know.
Friends of the show who want to be on the show.
No, soft. I'm just going to say what it is. If If you take offense to it, that's your fucking fault. Don't do it then.
True story.
There's just a definition, dog. Like, what? No, okay, a reseller is someone who purchases shoes for retail and resells it for a higher value.
Okay.
Done. Yeah.
They bought it for the purpose of selling it.
That was, yeah. That was a cleaner definition. Yeah. Okay.
You were expecting a worse one?
I was expecting a rant.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
All right. Joel,
no, I was expecting Quincy, the white guy, to come back.
The reason why there was no rant is it's unfortunately become part of the culture.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it is what it is, man. Like, honestly, through reselling, though, like, you guys have been able to purchase
shoes that you want.
So
there's no resellers. You can't get shit.
You know what I mean?
Releases.
Yeah, exactly.
So true. Yes.
And
so true.
There were times, like, Alan couldn't land it for the JTHs, and Gerard was able to.
Yep.
And now he got his pair, so it's good to go. So it's like, you can't really hate on them. You can if you want to. I'm not going to tell you not to, but it's a part of the culture, and it in a way, it helps people purchase the pairs that they want. So
definitely a double-edged sword.
Yeah.
For sure. Yeah. I agree.
Okay, let's wrap this up. Size run, Joel.
Size run. I don't even know what the fuck.
no?
A size run.
A size run is what a store holds, like the amount of stock that they have and what sizes they have.
Yeah, that's one size run.
I was going to say that.
OG. I don't know what this
10 and a half,
slang is that you're talking about. What's a size run?
Joel's going to tune into that segment.
My size run is 10, 10 and a half.
The size I run in is.
Okay. And then just some quick advice that I had is for beginners is stick to a few silhouettes for now. This also ties in with budgeting yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Things can get a little hectic, especially when you want all the new pairs that release every day, pretty much.
Things will always be around in some way.
Thanks, resellers.
Yeah. Thanks, resellers. Yeah, there you are.
Okay. Let's move on. Buying from GOAT. Lawrence Hopkins.
Buying from GOAT as a Canadian.
Yeah. You can read it on CanadaGotSold.ca or you can keep listening to this podcast.
What do you want to know, man? Any questions lined up for me? Well, or are you just going to fucking...
Okay. Let's pretend you've all read the article.
Pretend?
Yeah.
Pretend?
Yes.
You're pretending you read it?
I did read it.
But we're going to pretend.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Alvin, don't look at me like that.
No, I like it. I like it a lot.
Sassiness is here.
I can't see the laptop, Alan, but I feel like the article.
He's reading it?
I'm reading my notes. Would you order from GOAT again?
I would. I would order from GOAT again.
And go through all that trouble?
I would not do GOAT again first. I would like to try StockX.
Okay.
Just so I have a comparison, so I know which one I like better.
Yeah.
I did get a lot of advice from people after I published that, actually. And I asked people, a lot of people asked for advice. Apparently, GOAT only marks the packages at a max value of $195. So most of the time, people only had to pay $45.
Cool.
I wish I knew that before I did everything I did.
No way.
That's what I've heard. I don't know what kind of truth there is to that, but I don't know why people would lie at the same time.
Yeah.
But yeah, I would definitely order from GOAT again. Very user-friendly. Lots of updates, which I was concerned about because there's so many steps to the process from like your offer being accepted to the buyer, like confirming to shipping it out, especially because the shoe, when I purchased it, I don't even think the buyer had it in hand yet. Because it was purchased on Sneakers app,
one
right?
One of them ones.
It came out on Sunday, and then I think I made my purchase on Tuesday.
You're right.
I don't even know if he had it yet, so I was concerned. Like, I messaged GOAT, and they replied super fast. Very customer friendly. Yeah, I would definitely order from GOAT again. I would probably try the self-clearing thing.
Yeah.
A lot of people had questions as to what self-clearing was. Self-clearing is basically saving yourself the brokerage fees from the shipping company.
So if
UPS is charging you duties, half of or a lot of it actually is brokerage fees. So it's their own personal like
profit.
UPS charge for a service, air quotes, that they're providing you to have it cleared by the CBSA. So you can actually call UPS or whoever before it arrives to you, let them know you'd like to self-clear it, and then they'll drop it at, I believe, like a CBSA office, which is by the airport. You can go fill out some forms and just pay like just the duties, which is a lot less than what UPS would have charged you. Yeah.
Sweet. Okay.
Nice.
Yeah, so if you want to know more about that, please hit up our blog website, CanadaGotSold.ca. It's up there.
It is. Recent article, I believe.
It'll be the first link. Okay. speaking of all the raffles and stuff that were probably going to enter and go through for these Sean Waterspoons.
I've already entered,
I saw a comment a few days ago about how stores pick one winner to make it look legit.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Didn't someone DM us that?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I think I saw that in our DM. Oh, they must have picked... you. It was you because you won the Atmos.
Yes. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, from, they said, from Haven. I thought Haven backdoored. I guess they picked one person to make it look like it's legit.
Yeah.
What the fuck? Interesting. I don't even know where to start with that comment.
Wow.
Yeah.
So
Alan was the luckiest person ever.
Oh, man. I couldn't believe
we
it.
We all won a raffle?
I've never won from Haven.
Well, from like a raffle. Like
in general, like yes, I've shop. Won a yeah. raffle. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, I won the Fours,
the Cause.
The Cause Fours. Yeah, I won the Cause Fours.
That was so exciting. Oh, man. I screamed.
Me too. Me too.
That was crazy.
Yeah.
And you almost didn't buy them, I remember.
No, yeah. No.
You were like, I had to consult. Yeah. I was like, oh, my.
Marriage and baby life. Guys. Yeah. So you got to consult.
Holy smokes.
Priorities.
Yeah.
Either way, I was going to buy them. I just didn't know how to hide them. So I just told her straight. So that's what happened.
That's so
funny. Have you worn them yet, by the way?
They're, no.
Oh,
so that you're saying they're
DS?
DS. Oh,
they're dance dog. Oh, did I try them on? No, I didn't.
No, I don't think you did. No,
I pulled out. I pulled them out for pictures
of them.
So technically, they're not DS.
The dust un-DS them.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we've all won a raffle. I won from OVO for the White 12s.
Oh,
yeah.
There you go.
I won from Capsule for Tiffany Highs.
Ooh,
oh, that's a while.
A while ago, yeah. I've won. I won Big Bang Foams from Foot Locker. Yeah.
Oh, yes, yes.
Yeah. I've here and there, like, the odds are not great. You're going to win. Like, people think that, like, you enter and you're just, okay, when can
and
I pick it up?
Like, at these Toronto boutiques, we know no one.
Nobody.
Absolutely. Like, maybe we're friendly with them, but we don't, like, I don't have anybody's number.
Yeah, I don't have any personal relationship.
Plug. Episode 3.
Zero plugs.
Zero plugs.
I think that's the segment that's going to replace Alan gets GTHs.
It'll last the entire span of this whole show.
This whole season. And I'm okay with that.
That's fine.
That's all right.
Totally okay.
Yeah,
with
a lot
that.
Of people think that they just, as soon as they enter, they're going to win. Like the odds, especially because a lot of these boutiques, like Haven, it was online.
Mm. Yeah.
Bro, you get worldwide entries for that shit. Oh, Livestock, when it's online, like, bro, people are entering from all around the world.
Yep.
Like the odds of winning are so slim.
Yeah. And like when they do the Instagram raffles and it's
worldwide.
Like, oh, one comment per person. There's like 11,000 comments.
Yeah.
No fucking way people are commenting once.
But didn't you win from Livestock on Instagram?
Yeah, OVO I got
10s,
the OVO
right?
10s.
I remember
Jeez.
That.
Yeah.
That's, you're the only person I've ever seen who I know who's won one of those.
Because of so
many.
Raffle.
Yeah, because so many people enter those.
That's insane. Now, I love that Alvin brought up being a dad and a husband. Which brings us to a discussion that I've been meaning to have with you guys. I had a talk with one of my homies, one of our homies, actually, Caius. Shout out to Caius.
At Caius Tam on Instagram.
What up, Caius?
Caius Tam. Shout out to Kick Deals Canada.
Super dope dude. And we were talking about buying sneakers from other brands. And he asked me like why I don't do like start grabbing other pairs of Adidas and stuff like that. And I said it was because couldn't afford it and it's not in the budget and looking at like release calendars and stuff like that I actually noticed that Nike's ratio to other brands is like 3-to-1
like your personal collection
no like release calendars
oh really overall
yeah
oh,
okay. Mm-hmm. Like Nike drops a lot
hella
yeah
mm-hmm.
So I thought this would be a perfect topic for a newlywed that's me two dads two husbands same people, and a grill hunter.
Hi.
Do you guys think that a budget and sneaker diversity have any correlation at all?
No one wants to answer the question.
I want to say no.
Like, I do think that because I think that sneaker buyers are so impulsive and we're collectors of everything.
Yeah.
Like if you look at all of us, I'm pretty sure we have another collection of some random shit that we don't like Alan comic books, like whatever it is, like Joel with Supreme camps, whatever. Like we collect because that's just what we are. Like we're collecting people. So I know that if I start getting into NMDs or Ultra Boosts, I'm not just going to buy one fucking Ultra. I'm going to buy everything. I'm going to want this. I'm going to want that. So when I see like, whatever dropping that's not in my usual bubble of purchases, I'm like, no, I'm not going to go down that road. It has to be something super crazy for me to want to like jump out of my usual comfort zone and jump onto something else, because I know that it's just going to open Pandora's box and I'm going to be in trouble.
You know, with me, it's like I do want to buy pairs from other brands. Like I do want to start jumping in on Saucony and Asics. Shout out to Asics for their new Toronto flagship store. But yeah, no, I think I see Alvin, I think I see your mindset where it's like, even if you did have budget, you're probably going to end up buying more Jumpman and Nike stuff. Is that right? Is that how you're thinking?
No. My thought process is, if I want a shoe, I'll get it. Not necessarily when I want to get it, but I'll eventually get it. One day. It's just priorities, man. Like,
no, that's what I mean, though. But that, like, if you had the budget, if you can afford buying all these pairs from other brands, would you do it?
Not necessarily. Probably. Yeah. If I had the money, I'd have more New Balances and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's what you want at the time. Like, I don't know, man. Being like a fada totally changes, like switches shit up. So it's just...
So, yes. So it does have a correlation.
What?
Like having to budget and prioritize stuff like that. And
absolutely.
Dealing with sneaker diversity.
Yeah.
In your collection.
Even just choosing between releases.
Yeah. Like, oh, yeah, for sure.
Like even just prioritizing between, like not even budget, but like there's two releases, one's from here, one's from there. Like 9 out of 10, usually it's going to be me going for the Nike or the Jordan just because that's what I've
been collecting. Like this weekend, I'm going to forget about the Tinkers.
Yeah, I have to.
I'm going to go full force on the Sean Wotherspoons.
I did see that they're re-releasing at the end of April, though.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, the Tinker 3. Too. Yeah.
Perfect.
Exactly. When I saw that, I was like, thank God. Yeah.
What's in April? Oh, Shadow 1s. I think that's the only thing I'm looking at right now.
No, I can't.
Even then, I might just pass on those, to be honest with you.
I know Alvin wants
I think pair. I'm okay. Yeah.
We'll see what budget says.
Matches the sweater that you're wearing right now. Okay. This is a long episode. I'm very sorry, but we've had some pretty good discussions. I want to end this on a fun note. I want to try something new. This is called Max on My Mind. This is dedicated to Air Max Month. We're going to play a game. I have a Air Max in my mind and a certain colorway and a certain silhouette. And I want you guys... So it's basically 21 questions.
Okay.
Yes or no answers. And you guys are going to take turns asking these questions to figure out the shoe that I have in mind.
Okay.
So let's start. Let's start with Lawrence. He's looking at me intently.
Is it white?
There is white on it.
Okay.
Alvin?
Is it a 90?
No.
Is it an Air Max 1?
Yes.
Did it release after the year 2000?
Yes.
Would you consider it an OG colorway?
No.
Is the midsole white?
Yes. I love these. I like watching them. They're all looking at each other, trying to like pull from each other's minds.
Does it come in a red box?
Oh, I can't answer that. I don't know what box it comes in.
I know the shoe. Keep going.
Okay.
Is it a collab?
Yes.
Oh, shit. Maybe I don't.
Oh, shit. I have bra. Fuck.
Is the collab, does it start with A? Oh.
You can say the brand. Just say the brand, because then you're going to keep guessing.
Is it Atmos?
Yes. Oh, and if you guess the wrong shoe, the game's over. You guys lost.
Oh, what the fuck? Fuck.
Yeah, come on now.
Is there some sort of animal print on it?
Yes. It's Atmos. Duh, you wasted a question, bro. Come on.
Is it...
Not all... No, I'm not even... Biotechs don't have it. Anyways.
Is that... Okay, my bad.
Air Max 1?
Biotechs have a different midsole.
But they don't have animal print.
Oh, yeah.
All right. You. Please? Alvin?
So they're not biotechs. Is it, oh shit.
White.
Does it have.
Yeah, white bits. Do you guys want to recap?
No, does it have gray on it?
Yes.
Is it the.
You guys can discuss amongst yourselves.
Is there jade on it?
Yes.
Oh.
Wait, you guys can discuss amongst yourselves. Come on now.
Okay, don't let Alan listen. Don't let him hear.
Guys, it's obviously the Beast Pack. Are you stupid?
Oh, shit.
Joel, did you see what... if you guys... Okay, this is audio only, but Joel is... he's wailing his arm out, and he's going...
Guys, I think it has elephant print on it.
I think it's the Atmos.
I think it's Atmos elephant print.
I think it's the one that looks like a Jordan 3.
Yeah.
Final answer?
Final answer.
Lawrence, you can answer that.
Okay, we're back. Hey, Alan. Our answer is Atmos elephant print Air Max 1.
That is 100% correct.
Well, got it.
That is 100% wrong.
That was cool.
Never heard of.
No, I wouldn't. I would have done like all of the ones that if we are going to continue this in the future, if the listeners like it and if you guys like doing this, I will definitely pick a significant enough shoe that you guys will be able to guess.
Got it.
Okay. Cool.
I liked it. We can keep doing that.
For sure. Okay. And with that, we are going to wrap things up. Shout out to our boy Bram. Shout out to our Montreal brothers, the Sneaker Podcast.
Whoop.
Shout out to our other brothers, Matt and Zach, for helping us out with the podcast.
Yes.
And thank you to you, the listeners, for tuning in. We want to know what you guys think. If you have any suggestions and questions like the ones we heard today's episode, to give us some discussions, or if you guys want to know more about us and what we think of sneaker culture in general. This is True to Size. We are a weekly podcast. We talk about things in the sneaker industry, the sneaker world. We release every weekend. You can listen to us first on Podbean, iTunes, Google Play, YouTube, SoundCloud. On iTunes, please review and give us 5 stars.
5, 5, 5.
On the YouTubes, please drop us a like, comment, subscribe, and
subscribe.
Follow to us. Follow us absolutely everywhere. We have a little group on Facebook called CGS Talk. So if you guys want to jump in on that, that's facebook.com/groups/CGS.talk. That's where you can go to just have discussions about other sneaker homies locally and sell some shit if you really want to. Hit up CanadaGotSoul.ca for our latest pieces, such as buying from GOAT as a Canadian, our Under Armour Hovers review, and the Atmos Animal Pack 2.0 Air Max 1 review.
Yeah.
Yo.
I am Alan Martinez. You can find me at _Spooner with no E.
I'm Joel Hernandez. You can find me at Joe, J-O _ Dooney with 3 O's anyway.
I'm Alvin Quincy. You can find me at the @, that's the A with the circle. MISTERQ and then Mart.
And I have been Lawrence Hopkins. You can find me at @LDoggyStyles, 2 G's with an S at the end, not a Z, not a gangster.
You can find You can find all of us at Canada Got Soul. We are Canada Got Soul, and we are out. Talk to you guys real soon.
Peace.
Bye.
Oh, God.
Yeah, Viotex, you bitch.